I'm Aaron Fletcher.
I'm Christian Craig.
I'm Hunter Lawrence.
Josh Mode.
I'm Cameron McAdoo.
I'm Justin Brayton.
Hey, I'm Marvin Muskan.
I'm Malcolm Stewart.
I'm Jalen Ferranges.
And I choose Ogio.
I choose Ogio.
I choose Ogio.
I choose Ogio.
This week was really fun. It was a long week. There's a lot of big jumps and so many new futures that are out here. So kind of had to learn some new stuff. And Tyler tackled some of the bigger ones and put it together for comp day. And I'm pretty sore. It's been a long week here, just landing hard all week, over jumping, testing jumps. It's a lot on your body. So happy it's over. It was comp day today. It was the windiest it's been. So that just added a little bit extra stress on it. But super stoked everyone is safe and going.
So all week, the vibe was like, oh man, comp day doesn't matter. Like, Tuesday's fun, Wednesday's fun, Thursday night was really fun. We're not really worried about the competition element. And then I get here today, and a couple of you guys, it's serious. Like, you can see the gears turning, I can see you scoping out lines. How much different do fans and that kind of pressure make the riding for you, or if any?
Yeah, it definitely is some added pressure with the competition and all the fans come in. So it got serious today, and especially with the wind, everyone was just kind of had gnarly runs and then had to do it in the wind too. So that just added extra stress and scariness. So everyone was pretty quiet this morning, but you know, sessions are different because you'll do one thing gnarly and then you'll come back in and chill. Where in the run, I wanted to put everything I'd done gnarly all week in one run, which is just scary to do because these are the biggest jumps I've ever flipped and stuff like that. And then with the wind, and it's just scary. So to come out good, it's just a good weight off the shoulders to go home, and I want to go see my girlfriend and my dog.
Okay, I have to ask, because to uncork a couple things that you did today, sight unseen, you know, to do a big no foot can off that big of a jump, what's that like, dude? I was like, we'll never know. That's the highest I think I've ever seen a dirt bike.
Yeah, it's that thing's big, and especially with the wind taking your legs off, you don't know if it's going to shift to the side or anything, but I just wasn't even really thinking. I was just thinking points. So Tyler jumped that, and I knew if I did something over it, that would be extra points. So I just kind of went off. It's feeling good. I did a no-footer the first time. It was fine. So just went to the side with my feet and poked it out for like 3 seconds, it felt like, and landed. So I don't know. I was just thinking points and what I could do to try to back up my win last year. So, yeah.
Okay. Last thing, and I've talked about this to everybody. It's very cool to see where we're at right now with this. It's been a long time in the making, but to see guys like you, Tyler, Josh, the European guys that are coming into it now, it's very fun. Where do you see this going, and how fun is it to be a part of this new wave?
Yeah, I see free riding is kind of more like skate contests. I feel like you could go do like a skate contest and not even do a score. You could do a week full ride and have best whip. This dude hit the biggest jump. This guy did the biggest flip, and there could be different rewards like that, which what I think would be cool, because free riding isn't really about being better than one another. It's about going out there and having fun and doing what you like to do. There's no rules about it. So you could spin it off tons of different ways. And I don't know, the list continues. Slope style courses, I don't know. It just keeps going. So I see a big future for free riding for sure.
Man, insane week, insane course. This is the craziest course I've ever seen. As much as this is my imagination, this is Jason Baker and the whole Dream Trash crew imagination. They've been out here for 3 weeks, almost a month, grinding from sunup to sundown every single day. And this course speaks for itself, man. And to get all my friends here and put on a show was the most important. That was a win already in itself. In my opinion, free riding's not a competition. And what you saw the last 3 days of practice leading up to this, that's free riding. Us all riding together and working with one another to push each other in the right direction and create content. So it's cool that we had the contest day, but it's just a little bit different vibe. Everyone put down the runs that they wanted and finally had an open course of themselves. For the weather that we dealt with today, I thought it went really good. I've struggled on riding this whole week because I've been pushing through this injury that I'm just coming off of, and I've been riding through a shit ton of pain, and I took every morning off when everyone rode the course and only rode afternoons for 3 days straight. So I think I had a total of less than 2 hours on this whole course over the last week while everyone else was riding. So was still camp counselor, rode around on my 110 while everyone was, we kind of grouped up people in threes and let three sections of the course, let people move around after 20 minutes in each section so everyone can safely ride this course. There's so many jumps going every which way. It's pretty dangerous to have 10 people out there at the same time. So I think the way we broke it down was the best for everyone to learn the course and by zone. And then gave them an hour to put all the zones together. Yeah, man, for what it was, like, I didn't have much time on the course, and I was still, this morning I had about 15 jumps that I haven't hit yet that I had to click off this morning, and clicked them off, tried to put the whole run together, and ended up doing a bonehead move over here. Forgot where I was at, second gear jump, hit it in third gear, lugged the bike, came up short, and slammed, man. My no ACL knee is super swollen. I got cuts all the way up my leg, and there was literally a point in time that I was like, I'm not competing. It's like, to me, mission complete already by just creating this event and being able to be back on my bike for it. The last few days, like checking off some of these jumps that I had in my head, that was a win in itself for me. So competition aside, I had already won, and no matter what happened today, I could hang my hat on. I did everything in my power to do what I could, and mission accomplished. Today, I had to take my mindset to a whole new level to push myself through that pain. After that crash this morning, I was literally couldn't even walk. I was in so much pain. Crashed on the right side, right on my arm and my whole leg. I had to put myself through a crazy mindset just to get the gear on and go up there. And not only that, dealing with the wind and the 160-foot transfer was my first jump. So, that was gonna set the tone for my whole run. I got the transfer clean in the wind and set the tone for my run. There's obviously a lot of things that I wanted to do better in my run. But I completed the line that I wanted to do, but I wanted to do whips on a lot of stuff, do the tree drag that I did earlier in the week, do a lot of different things, but the wind was insane. Every time I tried to leave a lip and go for a whip or turn up or whatever it was, I was just getting blown from left to right. So just stoked, mission accomplished once again for me to just complete the line that I had in my head through this injury and push through the pain. And that's a win in itself. Axel beat me, much respect to him. He clicked off the two jumps that I had jumped before, and like those really put us a step above everyone else, even though everyone else had tricks. The biggest thing I'm stoked on is free riding is not a competition, and doesn't have to be the biggest trick. And I'm a racer at heart. I don't have tricks. I did one trick on the whole course, and that was a knack over here, and still got second. So it's not about tricks. That's the whole thing of this. It's about a blank canvas and how you see the course and the terrain. And Jason's a genius at building. Like, there's a landing and the size of all the landings are good, so you can have one jump that turns into three jumps, and there's so much opportunity out here. There's so many jumps, 125 jumps plus, but like the sides of everything are good. Like, when you really think outside the box of just the jump, there's so much out here. Like, I could spend a year here and find a year worth of things to do. I can't say enough. I'm just so stoked.
TB, you answered it all. I only have one other question, and it's because I was here on Thursday when you did that jump for the first time, and then to see like everybody's vibe after that. How different was it the second time on today, not only with the wind, because we know that's an issue, but to have so many people here and to know, I mean, dude, you probably had to feel like what Evil felt like back in the day when everybody like fills Wembley and wants to watch him do it.
Yeah, for sure. The other day, like those sessions when we're all feeding off each other, that's free riding in a whole. That is free riding, those sessions of us working together to push each other in the right direction and us helping each other get over these jumps and facing your fears of new jumps, and that is free riding. Like, I feel like if the fans were here for that, the fans would have absolutely went nuts for just the VIPs that were here that day and athlete support people that were here. everybody was mind blown. The reaction from what they saw was pretty priceless. So just fast forward to today, I had that jump in my head. I knew that was the first jump I wanted to do in my run just to get it out of the way so I didn't have to think about it. And I couldn't really hear the crowd because I was so in the zone, but to do that in front of the crowd and knowing that they hadn't seen that jump all day, was icing on the cake. I'd set out to do this line that I had in my head, and I completed that, so mission accomplished.
Yeah, that was a really rough day, really windy. I had a big crash during practice, so first of all, I was like, okay, I'm not gonna ride because it's super painful, and then the physio guys helped me a lot, so I was like, I wanna ride. I spent like 3 days practicing, so I was really, really looking for it. So I tried to do my best, and it paid off, third place, so I'm super happy with the pain and everything, so super glad I'm in one piece after this day of competition.
How was this? How was this for, you know, Belgian freestyle motocross guy to come to Kansas, USA, and see all these dirt jumps?
That's crazy, dude. It's a lot of feeling at the same time, like discovering a new place, discovering this kind of big jump. I only train on ramps, so for me it was like, oh fuck, these jumps are so huge. So yeah, this is a lot of feeling going through my head. I learned a lot. It's a lot of good people here, so yeah, it's positive, good vibes.
Is it fun to ride with all these people that, I mean, I'm sure you've ridden with some of them, but other guys know. So to get into this environment and just have 3 days this session with each other and get a vibe for everyone.
Yeah, that's for sure. It's such a good feeling for me. And then like practicing with those guys, that was the most good part for me because we all shared the passion and the same things on the bike, you know, and then the competition is something else, you know. So 3 days of riding with those guys, I meet so much good people, like the judge, so much legend here. So yeah, it's crazy for me to be here.
Hey, I have to say, you put yourself on the map this week, like that ruler flip, that super flip, that was so big.
Yeah.
And so to see that and it be unexpected was cool. How does it feel for you leaving now and knowing how the rest of your year will be?
Yeah, but the thing is, I was looking to do it on the run, but it's super windy, so I couldn't not. And yeah, to leave this this place here with, I think, some impact of my riding, and then to improve that a freestyle guy can be also a free ride guy at the same time, you know, so it's really good. I'm looking for next year, hopefully. And yeah, I will train and be better next year.
What's going on? That was so much fun. It's crazy. You almost feel lucky to just make it through the week and get out alive. So, super fun.
You know, I have to tell you, I've been watching you for a while. You're like Dennis the Menace for your neighborhood and all that. But I did not realize you had flips like that. I knew you could do big stuff, but that run you put out in that first one was big today. So how did that feel to go click that off after a week out here?
That felt so good. I'd say it's not part of the strategy, but I think a lot of people think I'm just like a beer drinking three-wheeler dude. But I've been working hard. Been working hard, and I love riding dirt bikes. And I just keep progressing and building. And then it's kind of now at the point where it's like, all right, this isn't by accident. Like, I deserve to be here. And then, yeah, I just keep kind of like raising my ceiling, and it's contagious. And this was just cool, man. It was just cool to come out here. I did all kinds of firsts. And I'm just grateful, happy to be getting out of here healthy. And you'll see some more improvement.
You know, to see the journey that you've been on in these last couple years, to think about the injury, getting a bike the way that you got a bike recently, like a lot of the stuff, and then to see the sponsors that you have and doing things your way, it's been cool. Awesome. You are one of those guys that really does have that free ride ethos that we're looking for right now.
Yeah. Yeah, it's the shred gods. I was just talking about it earlier. Like, my philosophy, it's just karma. Karma, but I call it the shred gods. And help someone fix a flat tire, tow someone off a jump, just be good, have a good attitude, be grateful, because I mean, if you know, anyone knows there's work, kids, family, bills, and you can't just always ride dirt bikes. So I'm always just grateful to be able to ride and to just keep going, and I keep going down the wormhole, and look at us now. And I hear a lot of people are inspired, and it's cool. And then people tell me, and I'm actually inspired by that because I'm like, all right, I'm just going to keep on going. So, yeah, just stoked.
All right, last thing. After you did your one run, you could tell that that was a heavy one for you, just a lot of those stuff. So
yeah.
How is that to just run through the week and then just be like, that emotional release at the end of it?
Yeah, I had a big release after that one because my dad, he passed away 8 months ago in January. Woo!
Sorry, I didn't mean
to. No, you're good. I embrace it because I'll go like a couple months and not feel anything and I'm like, come on. So no, that was a release for me. That, you know, it's just pushing myself. And then also, you know, like, yeah, you just after that, you're just like, oh. And I just was missing my dad because he was my best friend and my support and everything. And I wish he was here watching, and hopefully he's watching. But yeah, that's just that was just a big release. And I was kind of, you got strategy going through the week. And I was kind of, I laid off the gas pedal for pretty much that run. I'd have to go and watch it back. I'm sure it wasn't perfect. It's hard in this wind. But, that big old flip wasn't even scored. I didn't hear, I was going for like 5 minutes apparently, but that was just for me, really.
That's and, awesome.
My dad, yeah.
It was definitely amazing, you know, having the chance to ride with the best free riders in the world in this amazing course. It was definitely a good experience.
It's been quite the year for you. You've really come onto the scene quite heavy in just the last 6 months. How does that feel for this guy from Europe, where we're kind of in holding pattern for some time? You guys have really emerged over there, and now we all get to see it.
Yeah, it was definitely a hard work to make it to these big events. You know, I have my chance on next games. I got a bronze medal, so that opened the doors for me to come over here. So definitely, we need some time to adapt on the course since we don't have any of this free riding stuff in Europe. But definitely, it's good, inspiring, and it opened our eyes to see where is the sport going and the direction that it's taking. And yeah, definitely that.
Are you more of a ramp guy or a dirt guy?
Definitely, right now I'm a ramp guy. I'm a freestyle rider in Spain. I ride my two-stroke for the shows. So only for big comps like quarter pipe or here, I use my four stroke. So I think for next year, I need to change a little bit this stuff. But definitely I'm a ramp guy.
Okay. How is it to adjust to this then? Because this is so different. I mean, even to switch to a four stroke and the support that you have, you know that the pieces will be together when you get here. It's just a transition of your own.
Of course, you need to take it step by step. You don't want to miss anything. So we take it really slowly. First days I was just doing the easy jumps. So we increased the level day by day. And today I could do a top five. We just missed two jumps, like the gnarliest jump only Tyler and Axel hit, and the other gnarly jump only Tyler hit. Except these two things and the backflip, for the rest we dialed, so pretty good.
All right, what's the rest of the year look like?
Sorry?
What does the rest of your year look like?
My rest of the year looks pretty busy. I have a couple shows in Spain. I still have to do a competition in South Africa, Best Rip Comp, but definitely busy out there at home in Spain doing shows with my brother.
Good to know you guys have a lot of work going on.
Yeah. We are glad we can have a lot of work back home. Freestyle is like is still popular there. So yeah, it's really good. We can just make our living riding bikes.
This week's always gnarly. It's a cool event that these guys put on. Bereman, rounds everybody up to come out here and scare ourselves on dirt bikes and have a good time. And cool, this year we got a crowd, so that made it even a little bit cooler.
You know, you're a racer, so you've always had the crowd around. And earlier this week, so many guys were like, it's not about the competition, it's not this, it's not that. But then when everybody got here today, you could feel it go up a couple levels.
Oh, I mean, it's weird. It's hard to put free ride and competition in the same sentence. And I think they did a good job with it because you've got, you know, they build the course so gnarly that a guy like Tyler or even myself, who don't even take our feet off the pegs or just, you know, do any tricks, we can still, you know, be in the same sentence as these guys doing KOD flips and all that crazy stuff. And, you know, we kind of, you know, Tyler, I think, got second. I think I ended up getting bumped that last round to sixth. because I took, missed it. But, you know, it's just it's a cool deal. The course is so gnarly. It's just try to look cool, try to not make mistakes, try to hit some big, gnarly jumps. And I'm just pumped I'm safe and headed to World Supercross.
As the guy that has an eye on a lot of different stuff, pretty much every discipline of motorcycle riding, how fun is it for you to come here and see people from everywhere and all these different backgrounds come together and ride?
It's just cool to see all the different styles, you know? Like, I think I was kind of the only racer here this year. And then you got, like, some free ride guys. And then you've got, like, you know, Julian Vanstippen and, like, Navas and, like, those guys that are, I guess, freestyle guys mainly. And then you've got Axel, who's pretty much just transcending everything. He's got that racer background, but now he's got, like, a full... Like, I mean, he belongs in freestyle competitions now. Like, he can flip everything. He's got big tricks. And then Tyler's just got balls of steel, puts this thing on, eyes up some lines that he knows are going to scare everyone, and went and laid them out. I was kind of a little bit of a sissy this trip. Just like I said, in the back of my head, I'm, like, thinking about not letting everybody down with, you know, the World Supercross and CDR and all that. So I kind of had to reel myself in a little bit. But I still had a great time. This is always a week that if they're doing it, they can count me in. And I love it. It's fun.
Dude, it was unreal. I'm just stoked I survived the week. It's a gnarly course. So just to come out here every day and wake up every morning trying to get prepared to hit another big jump, it's hard. So just to be here finally at the end of the week, I did both my runs. I felt good about them. And I'm just stoked for next year now. So
you were... the big guy that I really wanted to watch this week, just to see how the progression went from last year to this year. Because when you came in last year, it was like, whoa, this kid's good. And it was certain things on your style that you had to start figuring out because you'd never hit anything like this.
Yeah.
To see the progression in 12 months, to know what you've done to move to California, to really take that next step. How does it feel 12 months down the road now?
I feel amazing. If my 10-year-old self saw where I was right now, he'd be jumping off the walls. So I'd have to say that I'm pretty freaking happy with life right now.
So the big thing that happens this week is just so much coaching that helps you guys, each other feeding off of each other. How does that help you wind up for a track like this, where you know that there's stuff out there that you've never even thought of, but now you get to do it?
Yeah, I mean, there's so many jumps out here that I've never even thought of hitting, and like, you got guys like Tyler and Axel hitting this big one over here. And it's awesome to have these guys to, you know, help tow you in and teach you how to hit big jumps like this, because really you can't find anything like this anywhere else in the world. Like, it's very rare, so it's pretty good.
All right, last thing, you're the next generation of free rider. You know, we have Tyler, we have Axel, we have Twitch and Renner that led the way before that.
Yep.
Where do you see this going for a guy like you in your early 20s right now?
I mean, you know, I'm young, so I'm in it for the long haul. I love the sport. I just want to keep progressing and keep riding my dirt bike. I love free riding. I love the sport, so I'm not going to stop.
That was crazy. Yeah, just so glad to kind of, you know, be here for the end. My whole plan was just to make it through the week. Came in so unprepared. Literally back home, it's been not only COVID, but winter also. And then, yeah, TB just hit me up as we've done some free riding together in the past. And, he hit me up and he's like, what do you think about imagination? And I was like, nah, not real good. But I just couldn't miss the opportunity. So because it was winter, yeah, literally got no riding in because it's so muddy and wet. And then just come over and just tried to gel with everything and just ride. But I was super, super scared when I got here because no riding, trying to get into all the jumps, but I think that's what I mean. I'm super happy just to kind of make it out safe, and the body's pretty bruised and banged up, but I'm actually kind of motivated to kind of get a little bit more riding done back home since everything's opened back up.
You know, you Kiwis, I was excited for this because you guys are
Australia.
You're Australia. Yep. I don't know why I thought you were New Zealand.
That's right. Same kind of area.
It is, but I know there's very personal. I'm not allowed to say that usually.
Yeah, no, that's all right.
But you guys go so big. Like, to see the freestyle scene that's down there,
yep,
to see Farm Jam that's down in New Zealand, to see, yep, crusty stuff that goes through Australia, it's a big deal down there. So to see the next generation of guys coming out of there right now is huge. How is it from your perspective,
yep,
as the dude down there right now?
Yep. Yeah, like the free ride scene right now, it's crazy. Like that's what I mean. That's what I enjoy. I just love riding with my buddies. You know, making jumps in the hills. You know, kind of throwing big whips, just having a good time on the bike all together. So back in Aussie, yeah, we have a couple of guys that we do a little bit of it with. So my buddy, Jackson Strong and like all those guys are kind of into it now as well. So we link up a little bit back home. So kind of as winter finishes, when I get home, I'm gonna get a little bit more fit and we'll kind of get back into it.
Is there a lot of natural terrain stuff like this down there? Like, I know Jacko's place is next level, yeah. But there's ramps and stuff. Yeah. Is there a lot like this?
Yeah, so back in Oz and New Zealand, like I personally think it's probably the best spot for free riding because we have the green rolling hills, we have the elevation, and then, you know, you don't have to literally cut out so much. So I feel New Zealand, Australia, we don't kind of have those jagged cliffs. So I'm hoping to see in the future this free ride scene move down to our area. Which would be unreal. The only bad thing is we have bad weather, but our summers are great. So if they can plan it for a summer, like they could run an event like this back home. So, but I'm just pumped to see, you know, this is the top, obviously, of free riding, and it's just good to see, you know, the heights, what's involved, the competitive side of it. So it's just been a really great experience for me. And like I said, just happy to be kind of standing at the end of the week and just kind of enjoying it with the boys. So
today was really gnarly. I don't even know where to begin. Actually, we had great weather all week, so it's a little bit of a bummer to the wind day comes on the contest day. But here I'm revving the bikes right now. There sounds like they're ripping their tires up right now, Axel and Tyler. You know, the course is amazing. I wish I could ride it all day. We're having some gnarly winds today, like 15 to 20 miles per hour with like 25 gusts, 30 gusts maybe. And it's hard to ride. Like we're not doing just little baby jumps out there. It's like a lot of stuff, especially the ones that have the crosswind are over 100 feet, like 140, 150 feet. So yeah, we did our best. We tried to be safe. We had a couple crashes, unfortunately, but everybody just tried to give the fans a show.
You know what I like about watching you, Tom, is that like you're this unassuming character that goes and does this stuff. Like you're very real about everything. You're just like, oh yeah, it's kind of sketchy. So then to see you kind of sack up and do all that is just so cool. How is it for you to get in that mode? Because yeah, you've been riding here all week and everything, but you're not a competition guy like that anymore. Like you do best whip and you do fun stuff, but to have to go put it out there on the line like this is a whole other level.
Yeah, I mean, I'm one of the older guys. I used to put it on the line a little more. Now I'm a little smarter, keep longevity and stuff. And I was out the first half of the year getting my shoulder fixed. So, you know, I really wanted to have a good year and make it all the way to the end. So, but the thing is, the course is so badass. The course it really is so fun and the fans are cheering. It's hard not to go out there and at least try and give it your best. Just at least try to get a few good whips out.
Hey, how is the shoulder? I noticed that you're not braced up and not as heavy as usual. Like, you seem like you're back to pretty close to full health.
I hope so. I mean, yeah, it was. I had to get it fixed in December, and you know, it's like 3.5-4 month injury, and then I've still been wearing a brace, a light brace, just the light EVS one, and then hopefully after this I'll start not having to use that anymore. I just didn't want to take the chance here. But yeah, it's getting better and stronger. So that was an issue for me last year. So it's nice to feel strong again. Like I did a bunch of jumps pretty quick that I didn't do last year because my shoulder, because I came in here after I dislocated it. So it's nice to feel strong again and be able to take some impacts and actually get out there with the young guys again.
This week was insane. I mean, besides today, it couldn't get much better. I mean, we had like the time of our lives all week long. That was
for sure.
Are you good?
I'm good. I think I hurt both my shoulders from impact, but I think I hurt my pride more than than anything else, and a little just added FOMO not being able to go out there and make a run in.
Don't worry. I'll tell you this. The vibe all week, there have been so many people that have been hyped on you and to see what you've done, that as much of a bummer as today has to feel, like the progress that you've made in so many other ways has been huge.
Absolutely. I mean, this week has been so fun. I mean, I've gotten to throw in some lines with Tyler before anyone else got here and just kind of like rip around, and we had this place to ourselves for like an evening, and that was like so fun and like special to be able to get to ride with Tyler after not being able to ride with him for months now. Just I've been on the East Coast riding at Brody Wilson's compound, and that place is actually kind of like a detour replica, and it's actually almost gnarlier than here in a sense, because there's like no safety decks and like super like tech landings and just not a lot of room for air. So it's definitely helped prepare me for to come out here and ride and compete, and it's been a great week. I can't complain, and I met all my personal goals of I wanted to just really not rely on Tyler or anyone to really need a toe in, and just be less timid as last year. I was definitely a lot more timid just from breaking my foot and not having any like reason why it broke, just too soft suspension and just landing funny and it broke. So coming into year two, I was super timid from that from year one. And then this year I set personal goals and I completed all my personal goals and just kind of fell short of the competition. So it is what it is.
Hey, good job being the first one over a couple of these things. Like to see that from you, I was like, yeah, that's it.
Yeah, I mean, that was kind of just a personal goal of just like, I wanted to come in here and like, just jump everything. Like I know my timing's been good. I've been riding a lot lately, and not to hold anything, like knock any of the guys, like I just needed to like put trust in myself and not have them guess for me. Like I wanted to guess and hit stuff first just so I could like push myself and become a better rider and not rely on them for anything. And my next goal to come here was just to like really get the creative juices flowing and just find different stuff. And Riff pointed out one to me, and I ended up jumping it on my own. And then I had a table coming back that I don't think anyone jumped either. And then the one that got me, I jumped that one a couple days ago without the added lip, and it barely put me on top. I was like, I squeaked by on it. And then I talked to Baker, and he threw a little bit extra on, and I rolled up it. And the minute I was going to jump it this morning, Julian crashed, and I didn't get to jump it. And then they gave me a practice run, and practice run was just full gusts. So I was just like, all right, we'll jump it in the warm up. And just miscalculated. I went and just gave it everything just to make sure, and I gave her way too much and sent her to flat. But it could be worse. Could be out of Kansas City Hospital, so I'll take two sore shoulders and a couple days of chilling. So could be worse.